Greg Anthony. They're just off a road trip in the heat, are looking to settle back in here at home. Game after game, the unbroken streak of wins to start their season continues.
And right now for Miami, it's been the kind of start to their season that a lot of experts were predicting. And by that, I mean a very strong start.
Well, the squad is loaded, and with the roster they have, anything less would have been a letdown.
So let's take a look at the Boston Celtics starting lineup. Thomas is the point with Bradley to his side. Mickey out there with Jay Crowder. And it's Sullinger in at the five.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And, Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
And so it's the Heat getting on the board first. Mickey. And no good. His first shot of the night missing. Wade kicks to Freak. Fires from 18. A rebound by the Celtics. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta.
And talk about a team that just never seemed to get into a rhythm offensively. It was just an ugly game to watch.
Yeah, that's an understatement. I mean, they didn't appear to have any kind of cohesiveness in terms of game plan. And they never figured out how to attack the defense in that one.
On defense, the Celtics. This game against Miami here, their first look at the Heat.
Yeah, and they're hoping for a better showing against this club this season. Last year, they came out on the losing end.
And, you know, with two teams in the upper pyramid in the early going, important to establish that pecking order, especially within your conference. So this game is important.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass, nice assist.
Sullinger, the screen. Pass to Mickey. Out to the right wing. Just five to shoot. Boston needs to get off a shot. And a little luck that time, but it drops.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Here's Freak. Cannot hit, and it's Boston the other way. And it's Bradley off the drive. That one falls, coming off of Thomas's feet.
Yes, sir.
It's all knotted up.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But boy, that was a nice job. The screenplay worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screenplay you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Now here's Thomas. His numbers are looking pretty good. He's got his scoring average up around 18 and a half points a game. Wash kicks to Wade. Dishes it to Freak. From 18 feet away. And Boston with the rebound.
You love the closeout on that possession.
Excellent defense. Active, and he made it a very tough shot for him.
Thomas, no luck. The Heat have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Expanding his range. And it's Freak missing.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
There's the pick. Thomas kicks to Sullinger. Now here's Crowder. He's covered by Whiteside. And it's good. Sullinger's got his first points of the night.
That pass into the paint, that is a work of art there. Dead on target.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
I was able to talk with Brad Stevens for a minute. A big factor in today's game, he said, is how they are able to handle Chris Bosch. He said often in games, Bosch is the X factor with his ability to gather rebounds and finish off chances inside. In order to keep him from dominating the fight on the glass, they'll have to match his intensity every step of the way. Guys?
All right, Doris. Now, here's Thomas. Following the miss by Freak, shoots from 12. That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him.
Just good, aggressive drive from him that time. Found a hole in the D and went straight to the rim.
Bosch, a screen on Thomas. Shot off the pick. It's Bosch, that time an assist by Freak. Bosch has got his second basket of the night.
How about the screen that frees him up, though, for the jumper?
inside. Here's Crowder, and he finishes nicely on the layup.
Really nice dime dropping there. Playmaking ability is exactly what you get from Isaiah Thomas.
Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Thomas. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. All right, we'll take a look now at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the Celtics.
Guys, right from the start, it's been apparent they're determined to establish a presence in the paint.
The other thing they've had going for them tonight is their passing. I mean, doing a nice job. Plenty of their points early on coming off assists.
Now here's Thomas. Pass to Mickey. A shot by Sellinger, wide open. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Sellinger's got 5 points so far. Looking at Miami, they took their win in their last game against the Bucks in Milwaukee.
And the deciding factor in that one was their success from the floor. I mean, they just hit big shots time and time again.
Yeah, just the way you want it with the road team. Don't even give the fans a chance to get into it.
Bradley dishes to Thomas. Back to Bradley. Fires the three. No good. And the Heat going the other way now. And a wide open look for Freak. The shot's good on the assist by Wade. And that's now 9 points for Freak. Take a look here at a very skilled bunch of point guards at the stripe. Look at the numbers they've put up over the last 10 games. Fifth on the list, Freak.
They are as reliable as ever.
At that point guard spot. But it doesn't happen automatically. I mean, these fellas are consistently working and practicing to keep that percentage as high as it is.
Now, here's Thomas. 8 points his last outing. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
Blatant contact. Straightforward call. Simple.
Taking two shots.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
That's a familiar sight. He hardly ever wastes his chances at the line. Cashes in regularly.
Freak with it. He picked up 27 points in their last win against Milwaukee.
Boy, was he physical. I mean, in that game, just drawing a lot of contact and getting himself to the line over and over.
You know, he'll make you scratch your head and throw your hands up as a defender. I mean, you just don't know how to play it.
Over in the corner, Turner. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And he bangs down the one-hander.
Two very easy points. Right there for
sure. He'll take those all day.
Bosch sets the pick for Freak to the inside. It's stolen by Bradley. Right side, Turner fires from the corner, and there are the Celtics with another basket. The Heat trail by four. Bosch, a screen on Thomas. Freak passes to Bosch. He used that pick to get in close. Bosch has got his third bucket of the night.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
Thomas goes in, kicks it to Crowder. And stolen by Freak. Bosch hits the pick for Freak. He gets stolen by Sellinger. Bradley against Wade. Bradley kicks to Thomas. The dish to Sullinger. Sullinger with a screen for Turner. Shot clock at 6. Thomas with the ball. And Bosch picks him up defensively. They get it back. Out to Turner. The pass to Sullinger. Tries again. And Sullinger missing.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
The feed now to Stoudemire. He dishes it to Freak. And Thomas over to help. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
And a look at how the Celtics performed over the last month here, Kevin. 6th in field goal percentage. 7th in opponent points per game. And they're in the top 10 in rebounding. This is a team that does a good job getting on the glass.
And you mentioned their opponent's field goal percentage ranking. They do a really good job of closing down the paint, forcing teams to beat them from outside.
Here's what Miami's going with right now. Johnson comes in for Chris Bosh. And it's Dragic in for Dwayne Wade. And then for Boston. Wallace is checked in for Jay Crowder. Smart comes in for Avery Bradley. And it's Rozier in for Thomas. For Miami, they've gone 7-13, just over 50% from the floor. Some good looks. So they take the lead. And that's 13 points for Freak.
This switch has definitely been flipped to on this quarter, guys.
Now here's Smart. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Pass to Rozier. He kicks to Smart. They set the pick. Feeds it to Turner. Trying to get back on track. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
Stoudemire, the screen, and it's going to be a 3-second call. And Miami making a change here. Richardson's checked in. Josh! Second quarter of play with around 2 minutes gone so far. Some firepower, Clark, from this offense.
Yeah, Kevin, how about the air of confidence? I mean, they really look like they believe in what they're doing.
Yeah, they got a nice groove going right now offensively.
On the floor for Boston. Jay Crowder out there with Bradley. Then it's Thomas. And it's Mickey in at the 5 down low.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
That one is off. And the second free throw, good. The Heat have gone 1-6 from the field in the second quarter. It's been a rough period so far. Now here's Freak. D right on him. Over to the wing. The wide open look here for Bosch. And he hits it to tie the game up. Bosch has got 8 points. Boston's gone 3-4 from long range in the game. Passes to Thomas. And stolen by Freak. And dang, here we go. Wade. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact in. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. 2.
All right, now, gentlemen. 2 shots. Loose shots.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. Both free throws good from Wade. Boston shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. Thomas kicks to Crowder. They set the pick. Here's Monsees. And he's good on the 3 ball. And the Celtics lead by 1. Several lead changes going on here in the early portion of this game.
Yeah, but neither team really able to jump ahead.
It reminds me of that Cameo song, Back and Forth.
Okay, well, let's check in with Doris Burke reporting from our sideline in this game. Doris, take it away.
Well, Kev, Freak, in the last matchup against the the Bucks had a nice performance. He finished with 27 points and also had an incredible amount of assists, really setting his teammates up every minute on the court. It's games like this that have propelled his team to wins early on this season.
All right, Doris, thank you. It really was a stunning performance. He was at his absolute best in that game.
And if he can come anywhere close to another performance like that here tonight, it would be amazing.
Yeah, it really would be, because you know now the defense is going to be focused squarely on him. They're going to make sure that he doesn't beat him again.
Boston's gone a very strong 4-for-5 from three-point land in the ballgame. And Thomas, here we go. Let's it go with a three. Miami grabs the miss. Bosch has got his third rebound tonight. Now here's Freak, guarded by Bradley. Freak kicks to Dang. The three from Bosch. That's another one for him. His fifth in just 7 shots.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding, and they're piling up the assists.
And that one is hammered home.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that.
Now here's Freak. He's covered closely. He feeds it to Whiteside, and it's Dang in the corner. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. 4 on the shot clock. There's Freak. A basket good off the assist from Wade. Wade's got his 4th assist in this one.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Who are the league's best setup artists? Check it out. Freak, number 1.
It's hard to argue with his status as the best passer in the NBA right now. He just distributes the ball so well.
The Celtics have gotten a little under 50% of their second quarter shots to find the mark. 4 of 9 all told. Dishes it to Thomas. Another field goal for him. 4 for 6 shooting tonight.
What a job he's doing here. I mean, his second quarter has been even better than his first, and that was pretty good.
Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Thomas. Here's Freak. Rebound, Boston. Bradley's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Outside, Thomas. Feet out. Here's Monsees. And they had their chances. 2 offensive rebounds, but they still come up empty. Here's Freak. 18 points for him. Pass to Wade. Kicks to Freak. From deep. Good for basket number 7 tonight on a not-so-unlucky 13 shots.
He's certainly starting to heat up from outside. That's his 3rd for the game, his 2nd in this quarter.
Thomas dishes to Crowder. Thomas a screen. Crowder with it, and Bosch picks him up defensively. Bradley passes to Thomas. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. Whiteside's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Now here's Freak. He's guarded close. And here's Bosch for 3. Good for another bucket. He's made 6 now. 6 for 8 on the night.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all day. Even last game, he was on fire.
Pass to Mickey. To the left side wing. The 3. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. Whiteside's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. And here's Freak. He's got 21. The second chance effort. Whiteside, no good.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Now, here's Bradley. 14 points from him the last game against Atlanta. Out left of the wing. From downtown. And it's Miami with the rebound. Now here's Freak. Great numbers on a nightly basis as he averages over 24 points a game. There's the dish to Bosch. And it's Miami with another.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
And so he draws the foul on the shot on trip to the line to shoot two.
It's really an extraordinary game for Thomas. He has 12 points. He's come up with a couple of nice steals today, too.
Clark, just a very energetic brand of defense.
Boy, they're really battling, guys. Not sitting back, being aggressive, attacking when they have the chance. I like that.
Man, I like their approach to the game right now. There's tremendous aggression on both ends, putting the onus on the officials.
Catching up on the changes with Miami. Stoudemire's checked in for Whiteside. Johnson comes in for Chris Bosh. Winslow's checked in for Lou Aldang. And it's Dragic in for Dwayne Wade. And Freak gets it to go on the assist by Dragic. Freak's got the lead up to 8 now for the Heat. Austin's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. It's Ellinger with the drive. And the pass to Freak. Stoudemire setting the pick for Freak. He's looking for Stoudemire and finds him. Stolen by Smart. Now it's Thomas running. He can go all the way. And the shot's good from Crowder.
Terrific job on both ends of that sequence. Very slick steal and then excellent transition offense.
And really it all stems from the aggressive defense. That's exactly what the doctor ordered.
Here's Johnson. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
They've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but also the body movement off the ball that's created a lot of those opportunities.
And so we conclude the first half. Heat lead by 10. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, what a great job you did, both moving the ball and passing it and scoring it. What has been the key for you to this point?
I don't really think there's a good key. That's what you're supposed to do on the basketball court, right? I guess the one other thing is rebound, so I'll try to focus on that for next time.
Good luck with that, young man. Kevin, a young talent looking to do whatever it takes to make it in the NBA.
Thank you, Doris, and we'll be right back after halftime for the start of quarter number 3.
Okay, guys, solid play so far. I like what I'm seeing. But just a few things to talk about before the second half. Number one, I love the teamwork we're seeing out of you guys. We're tearing them to shreds without passing at the offensive end. Let's keep that going and pile up those assists. I'll say this for us, though. Our shot selection has been terrific. We haven't forced things, and the shots are dropping for us because of that patience. And let's try to play the second half at a moderate pace. Not too slow.
And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. You look at Freak in this game, he has been everywhere.
And the thing I noticed most in that first half was his offense. He was not wasteful with his opportunities and also did a great job of converting with the chances he had.
I agree with you, Greg. Judicious shot selection. All of his looks were good looks.
Dang and Bosch, your small and power forwards. D-Wade out there with Freak, and it's Whiteside in at the pivot, manning the middle. So that's who Eric Spoelstra starts the second half with. It's tipped. It's stolen by Sullinger. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Outside for Thomas. Shot, high post. It's hauled in by the Heat. Bosch has got 4 rebounds in this game.
They've done their part here to run down a lot of missed shots. A solid rebounding effort.
Yeah, energy has been the difference, and they're fighting for every loose ball and giving as good as they get on the inside.
6 to shoot. The shot by Wade, wide open. Connects from 3-point range.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
Now Thomas. He's got 14. Crowder with it. Outside Thomas. Puts up a 3. And it's Miami with the rebound. Whiteside's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Freak kicks to Dang. Good ball movement here by the Heat. And Chris Bosch with the slam.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket for the jam.
They did seem to take the cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
And, guys, it's not the time for caution now. I mean, they've got to be aggressive and take some risk to see if they can cut that lead down.
And he gets it to go.
Assisted Jordan.
The Heat leading by 11.
Got it. Get the ball inside.
And stolen by Thomas. And Whiteside sends it back. And they'll keep possession. Miami's gone 6 of 8 on 3-pointers in the game. An outstanding 75% mark. Whiteside a screen on Bradley. Here's Freak. And he comes off the screen and skims it through.
And, you know, that's an example of how many plays we have in a game for which there's no stat. A monster dunk.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor, isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
Boy, that's a sound physical play. I mean, can't be afraid to put a shoulder into somebody every once in a while. It's a contact sport, folks.
A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Thomas kicks to Sullinger. And stolen by Whiteside.
You got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Thomas. And here's Freak. 25 points in the game. The shot by Bosch. And there's another one for the Heat.
Boy, it's been a great start for this offense here in the second half. 4 for 4.
Celtics trail by 15. Here's Thomas. 14 points for him. Pass to Mickey. He dishes it to Sullinger. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Sullinger's got 12 in the game.
He's one of the best in the league at that. Even with just a tiny sliver, he always seems to find a way to get it up and in.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Let's spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
Here's a look at some of the most multi-dimensional players in the NBA. Not only can they pass, they can fill it up. up the highest scoring point guards this season. Freak third.
Well, this is a collection of maybe the most well-rounded players in our league. I mean, to see those kinds of scoring numbers from the point guard position is crazy.
Yeah, and that's the age we're living in right now. I mean, it's not uncommon to see a point guard lead his team in scoring, which used to be almost unheard of. And these guys here are all capable of carrying the scoring load for their team on any given night.
Bosch with the bucket.
Wow, five straight buckets coming out of half. They are rolling.
Celtics trail by 15. Thomas dishes to Sullinger. And stolen by Freak. And here we go. Fast break. Freak's got it. That's good. 9 points for Dwayne Wade.
And it's all one-way traffic tonight, boy. They have been lights out offensively.
And there's no telling how big that lead's going to get. But, again, it's just one game. But, nonetheless, a very impressive one, the way they've handled their business here.
Sullinger, no good.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
You know what? No rebounds, no rings, and they've controlled the boards, and that's what's given them control of this game.
Boy, this is the kind of shooting performance coaches dream of. It makes their job. So much easier. An excellent start to this third quarter.
It's Bradley on the wing. Wade is covering to the wing on the left. There's a screen. In the corner, Bradley with it. Five to shoot. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
Now here's Freak. He's tightly guarded. Here's Dang. Shot is no good. So the Celtics will take it the other way. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Sullinger with the bucket.
Despite the troubles he had in the first half, he stayed composed and focused, and now he's getting it going.
Bosch hits the pick for Freak. The feed now to Bosch. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
You know, Bosch is playing really well. 22 points, and he's got two baskets from out in three-point land.
And I'm sure they'd like to get a few more of those out of him.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
That's bad, man.
Celtics trail by 20. Now, here's Thomas. He's got 14. He kicks it to Sullinger. They set the pick. Bradley drives in. Pass to Crowder. From 13 feet, it goes down. Crowder's got 6 points.
And he's been passive today, but maybe that's what he needs to get him going, because for them to be successful, he's got to be a little more selfish.
Bradley on the double team. Feeds it to Dang. Six to shoot. To the wing right side. It's stolen by Bradley. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Thomas passes to Sellinger. Nice ball movement by Boston. To the wing right side. Sellinger the screen. Crowder with it. He's picked up by Dang. It's deflected and stolen by Whiteside. Wade kicks to Dang. Outside Bush. Double team on Bush. Passes it to Freak. He feeds it to Dang. Wade on the wing. Miami no good on that time either.
You know what? You just cannot get much better of a look than that one.
Exactly. I mean, no way you expect him to miss that shot.
And you can see he just caught a glimpse of the open man on the perimeter and immediately got him the basketball.
You got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Thomas.
Move the ball. It's sticking too much.
Whiteside sets the pick for Freak. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Freak's got 27.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
And the Heat going with the whole new group on the floor. And Celtics trail by 14 on the floor for Boston. Thomas is out there with Smart. Then it's Turn. Then it's Jay Crowder. And it's Mickey in at the center position. Smart kicks to Thomas. And he gets the bucket. Thomas got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the Celtics.
Kevin, he's been a bright spot in what's otherwise been a little bit of a struggle for this team.
And stolen by Thomas. And the foul called on Freak. That's his third foul of the game. The Celtics making a switch here. Bradley's checked in.
Avery Bradley.
And Boston has possession. Down by 12. On the wing, Turner. And play stops. Whistle on what looks to be an illegal screen.
I didn't really expect him to turn it over as many times as he has in the second half. It's caught me by surprise because before the break, he only had one.
The kick out to Bosch. And again, Miami with the triple.
Add another triple to their second half total.
They came out of the break just dropping bombs and just are not letting up at all.
A floater, Bradley, no one around him. That three off the mark. The Heat leading by 15.
Got it. Get the ball inside.
A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played. Freak kicks to Winslow, takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
And really nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And, Greg, they do need to get going. They wouldn't mind, you know, shaving a couple more points off that lead right away.
Well, if the defense keeps giving up easy baskets like that, it won't be a lead for long.
Bosch, the screen. Six on the shot clock. And Thomas over to help. Here's Winslow. Here's Whiteside. Nice work on the boards. Paying off with the basket. And the Heat lead by 17.
And the interior D is really starting to be exposed here. How many layups have they gotten today?
And it's blocked by Whiteside. Now here's Freak. Tight defense on him. Dishes it to Whiteside. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Flying high and throwing down the hard one-hander.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
And really, he does that one as well as anyone. Kev, you're right. That's like his signature move once he goes airborne.
Here's Winslow. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Wade's got his sixth assist on the night. And, guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Heat.
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ball game.
Yeah, and also the way they've been able to generate points off of the turnovers that they forced tonight has also helped.
Luol Deng has checked in for the Heat, and a change for the Celtics. Sullinger's checked in. Good on the second free throw. We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in. Now, Freak kicks to Whiteside. Here's Freak. Again, the Heat, good for two.
Just carrying the load right now offensively, guys. He is not wasting any chances.
From where I sit, Greg, it's a simple deduction. If they want things to be easy on themselves here late, make sure he has the ball.
Wade against Bradley. Five on the clock. Trying to break that ice-cold streak. Kept alive by Boston. Sullinger. And Whiteside sends it back. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touch by Whiteside. The dish now to Bradley. The pass to Thomas. Clock at six. Here's Sullinger.
He had a couple in the first, but so far he's been unable to get uncorked here.
And Sullinger missing.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
And he gets it to go. And 11 points for Wade.
Boy, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. Excellent.
Four straight passes leading to scores. Great team play.
Outside Thomas. There's the three. Good on the shot. Thomas got 22 points.
And they've got to talk to each other on D there. Miscommunication. And now he's able to make a pay.
Now here's Freak. He's guarded by Thomas. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Terrific game for Freak. He has 29 points and the assist numbers tremendous.
His court vision is on par with anybody. I mean, he could not pass the ball any better than he is right now.
And so he makes both from the line.
Can you believe the job they're doing at the foul line since halftime? I mean, they've been perfect so far.
Yeah, as cool as can be, Clark. Great focus and efficiency. That's how they built this lead.
Bradley dishes to Sullinger. Pass to Thomas. To the middle. Here's Mickey. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. That's on Dwayne Wade. At the line for the Heat, Jordan Mickey. At the line for two. No good on the free throw. And he's good on the second. The Heat leading by 22. Freak with it. Bosch a screen on Thomas. Here's Freak. Goes back up. And the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
A great job getting the ball inside right now. Coach really wants them to show some physical presence and toughness here in the second half. And that's exactly what they're doing.
Sullinger outside. They double in with Freak. And Thomas, here we go. And he lays it straight in. Thomas got 10 points in just the second half.
Just a positive force right now for these guys. And though his team has fallen a bit short, it's not because of him.
And Thomas over to help. And it's Whiteside. That time on the assist by Freak. And it's 8 points now in the game for Hassan Whiteside. Here's Sullinger, and he banks in the layup.
You know, that's a case there, Kevin, of him making a pass to a spot, and then he let his teammate run right into it. Well executed.
And here's Freak. Whiteside a screen. Freak passes to Whiteside. Just five on the clock. It's stolen by Bradley. Whiteside, Thomas. Sullinger with a screen for Thomas. And Sullinger kicks to Thomas. And stolen by Freak. And here we go. Freak heading to the hoop. Rips down the breakaway slam.
That's a quick bucket there. Solid in transition.
Well, you know, he loves the chance to get out and run, and we could see right there why he does.
And Thomas, here we go.
What are you doing? Stay down. Stay down.
Chris Bosh. That's his second personal foul. Shooting for Miami, Isaiah Thomas. At the line for two.
And the first one at the line is good. And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team, Clark, by far tonight.
No question about it, Kevin. They certainly gave their fans plenty to scream and holler about. This place was rocking. It was on fire. And it only got louder as that lead got bigger.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Once again, your ability to make plays with your passing was a major factor in this one. How did you get the offense clicking?
It's like this. You set a tone at the top. Everyone in need follows.
Yeah, hold on.
Made sure we were all on the same page tonight. Everyone in need me.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Thank you, Kevin, and now we get a chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Freak. Just a monster first quarter of the game. He came out hot and just never cooled down. That boost he gave his team early on, a huge factor.
Ernie, that is the definition of domination. He took them to school tonight in every possible way. I know there's 10 players on the court, but I only noticed one.
That was Freak turning up the volume right there, baby, all the way up to 11. And the stereo only goes to 10, Ernie, but we're at 11 right now. The man himself may be quiet, but his performance spoke very loudly.
And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a good night, everybody.
Okay, guys, we need to pick up the intensity. Boston drill, Here we go. Okay, everyone, we obviously need to be better in the open court with the ball. Let's set up in 63. Okay, we're good on the drills for now. Let's make sure we're getting better every day.
Thank you. Thank you. mess around. Your shimmer takes my eye. I lift my head, blind by the sky. Feel my way in front, following the sound. You move to it so fast. To come, jump back to my
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
I'm Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. This NBA season rocking right along, and we're loving every minute of it. In a few moments, we'll be sending you out to Miami as the Heat go up against the Chicago Bulls. For Chicago, playing under 500 basketball over the last 10 games, they can do better, and they'll try to get on the winning side tonight. Somebody we're going to be keeping an eye on tonight. What a story for this guy. Hassan Whiteside. He was a journeyman, and then last season, man, just exploded back onto the NBA scene. What do you make of what you've seen of Whiteside, Shaq?
You know, Ernie, he's got incredible height and wingspan, 7 foot. He blocks a ton of shots. Gets better every year, gets better every game. He's getting more comfortable. And you can be comfortable in Miami when it's 80 degrees all the time.
Without question. But if he can control his emotions.
Let's meet the visiting team, the Chicago Bulls. At small forward, Doug McDermott. At the other forward position, Taj Gibson. At center, Joakim Noah. At point guard, Derrick Rose. At the other guard position, Jimmy Butler. The head coach of the visiting team is Fred Hoiberg. At small forward, at 6'9", number 9, Luol Deng. Number 1, Chris Bosh. Starting at center, 7 feet, number 21, Hassan Whiteside. Point at 5'9", number 93, Freak Eric Spoelstra is your head coach. Yo,
the International Conference battle with the American. Arena here in Miami, Florida, as the Heat look to work the home court advantage. And as we start the weekend here on this Friday night, 2K Sports welcoming you to NBA basketball. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, and on the sideline tonight, Doris Burke. Taking a look at Chicago, they've hit a rough spot here early, but still have plenty of time in their season to find their way out.
And you know, for the Bulls, they've started the season with a little bit of a chip on their shoulder. They had a lot of people with doubt heading into the season, and I tell you what, they are out to prove those folks wrong.
And they're doing it, Greg. I know it's still early, but they've already shown they can compete with the best teams in the league.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So for Chicago right now, the big men are Gibson and Noah. Rose is the one with Butler is the two. And it's McDermott in at the three spot. Chicago with the ball. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
And talk about a team that just never seemed to get into a rhythm offensively. It was just an ugly game to watch.
Yeah, that's an understatement. I mean, they didn't appear to have any kind of cohesiveness in terms of game plan. And they never figured out how to attack the defense in that.
And here we go. Deng heading to the hoop. And Freak throws it down.
Great hustle to turn the block shot into a fast break hoop. That's a big time play.
A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Rose kicks it to Noah. Gibson the screen. Right side against Noah. There's the dish to McDermott. His three pointers off the mark.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, it seemed like he had great rhythm on that. You can see the disappointment in his face.
Now here's Freak. Boy, he was something else against Boston. To the inside. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Stolen by Noah. Rose goes in. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. The Heat have gone 2-3 here to start off the game. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. What'd you find out, DB?
We talked about the strategy as it applies to D-Wade. He said said, Dwayne can score at will when he gets into a rhythm. So our job is going to be prevent him from getting into that rhythm in the first place. Because if we can't do that, the points will just pile up. Most opponents are completely aware of that, guys.
All right, Doris, thanks. Now, here's Wade, following the miss by Chris Bosh. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation.
Chicago ball.
The Bulls have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right. Gibson. And the Bulls with another miss.
Boy, after the first three misses, I thought they'd get one here, but they still can't connect.
Whiteside, a screen on Rose. Whiteside kicks to Wade. Shot clock at 6. Shoots a 3. That. One's off. He's now 1-for-2. Bulls trail by 4. Outside Butler. He dishes it to Gibson. Gibson setting a pick for Rhodes. The Bulls keep it alive. The shot by Butler. Nobody around. Good, and a nice assist from Noah.
He can be a weapon if he gets going early from long range.
Quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Right side a screen. Down low, McDermott with a steal. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. And the foul called on Freak. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Yeah, and I like this call because you want the refs in that situation. If there's any doubt, err on the side of giving the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player. That should have been a block, and it was.
They set the pick on its way from Rose for 2. Rose with another miss. The Heat with the lead. Here's Freak. He's a guy we see deliver on a nightly basis, averaging about 24.5 points a game. The Heat shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one.
Chris Bosh.
A free throw drops for Bosh. Both good from the line that time.
Boy, I tell you what, he does not look like your typical big man up there at the line. He has an excellent stroke and a percentage to match.
Butler passes to Noah. And it's off the back rim, no good.
You know, they don't score on that shot, but they're going to be happy with those kinds of possessions.
Bosh, the screen. Freak dishes to Bosh. Here's Whiteside, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
Butler kicks to Gibson. Wants to get it to Rose, and does. And Whiteside sends it back. And here they go. And it's Wade. That time on the assist by Bosh. Wade's got his first 2 points.
No doubt that is within his range.
Well, I would hope so. He's a pro, and it was only a one-footer. Come on now.
Butler passes to Rose. And the shot is good.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did.
Oh, that was a nice job. And check out the bounce.
Bounce to the ounce. Clark, how about that?
Yeah.
All right. Showing him off right there. Good move.
You said it, my man. He's a highlight reel waiting to happen.
Gibson dishes to Butler. Noah with a screen for Butler. Pass to McDermott. Just 4 to shoot. Gibson. Good, and a nice assist from Noah. Gibson's got his first basket of the night.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Now, Freak. Bosh hits the pick for Wade. Rose with the double team. and he gets the bucket. Freak's got his second basket of the night.
They've got themselves in front with some outstanding shooting right off the bat.
It's been a complete technical dominant performance out here. They are in. A zone.
Okay, Miami, now coming up to the court are your Heat dancers. Let them hear you.
And how about the numbers here for Noah? Sixth in rebounding.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Portis, he's checked in for Noah. And Mirotic subbed in for Taj Gibson. Now here's Rose. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Golden State.
And defensively, guys, he was just all over the place, forcing turnovers and applying terrific ball pressure.
Here is Rose. Here's Portis. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. And we get a moment to check out the team scoring leaders. Number one, the Heat.
I mean, it's an exciting brand of basketball that they're playing. They've got such deadly weapons. Teams have had a heck of a time trying to slow them down.
Good on the second free throw. Here's Freak. And he slams it one-handed.
And what a beautiful way to polish off that sequence. Just strong at attacking the rim.
That just puts a little more momentum on their side, don't you think?
Absolutely.
The defense got to tighten up now. I mean, you can't have the opposing point guard throwing down on you like that.
Heat leading by six. Bosch is screen on Rose. Here's Freak. Pops loose off the pick and hammers it home.
And it was the screen there, guys, that freed him up as he ran his man into it.
And then it was all acceleration, GA, to the bucket right after that.
Almost a backboard breaker. Well, that defense went from four to no defense at all.
And when he's open.
Sorry, guys.
Like that, you don't see him miss those looks very often.
Now here's Freak. He's got eight. Dishes it to Whiteside. Dang with it. Butler covering. And now it's a double-digit lead. And now it's an 11-point Heat lead.
And a huge lead here early to start.
Well, you know, right from the tip, there's not anything they haven't done well so far.
Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Butler's got 5 points so far.
He's looking confident right from the opening tip.
Freak with it. The pass to Whiteside. Bosch going around him. And again, Miami with the triple.
These defenders had better start closing out on those shooters.
That's two in a row, and we call that a streak.
Rose goes in. Tries again. The kick outside to Butler. Offline with his three. Looking at Miami, they took their win in their last game against Boston.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Yeah, it was a mismatch. I mean, the defense from the start was on its heels practically the entire game.
Mirotić gets the bucket.
Mirotić.
I ain't even gonna sleep yet, bro.
Timeout call.
Give it up for your Heat Dancers.
Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season. Taking a look at Miami. They like where they stand right now, perched in that topmost position.
I'm 15 and 0. I'm trying to go for it.
I'm just one spot down.
And for Chicago, they have performed above and beyond expectations thus far. As good as they've been, is it fair to wonder just how long they can keep this up?
Of course it is. I mean, I'll tell you this. They may have stuck up on some of their opponents in the early season, but they're not sneaking up on anybody anymore. Teams will be ready for them.
And here is Felton following Chris Bosh's three. Outside, Felton to the right side. Miritich has a wide open look. That's good, and so Felton has the assist there.
Only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball with one of their own.
Greg, we've got a three-point battle taking shape here.
Now here's Freak. 8 points for him. Stoudemire, the screen, to the inside. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
I got so many.
Stoudemire's got his first basket.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime dropping delights is what I call it.
That is a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he was on the money, that's no doubt. Here's Butler. He's coming off a 16-point game against Golden State.
Yeah, but I also thought the rebounding was impressive. He got some huge boards in that game. They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Yeah, sensational is a really good word for it, Greg. They're tearing this up on the glass.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
And it's the Bulls with the ball. After Justice Winslow getting his shot to go from deep, Miritich with it. And Bosh picks him up defensively.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
1-12 left to play in the first quarter. Stripped it away. Felton goes in. And it's Miami with the rebound. And going against Chicago, their first meeting of the season.
And on paper, you'd call them the better team, but they actually lost the season series against this group a year ago.
Yeah, it was a surprising outcome for me and you. But hey, sometimes matchups can play out a certain way.
Subbed in for Goran Dragic. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Joakim Noah is checked in for Portis. Gibson comes in for Miritich. Doug McDermott, he's checked in for Butler. And it's Rose in for Garrett Temple. Wade and Dang are the 2 and 3. Whiteside is out there with Winslow. And it's Freak in at the point. That's the group on the floor for Miami. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Celtics got down to business. He finished with 33 points and also had an incredible amount of assists, really setting his teammates up every minute on the court. Numbers like that make you anxious to see what he can do next time out.
Great, Doris. Thanks. Any chance we see him top that performance right here tonight?
You know, I can't imagine he'd be able to pull off that kind of an outing 2 games in a row. But, hey, that's what the truly great ones are capable of doing.
Boy, even if he came close to matching it, that would be really impressive. But I tell you, that's asking an awful lot of one guy.
Plays like that, the hustle plays on the backboard, the second chance points that have really caused problems all day for the defense.
Felton against Wade. It's stolen by Wade. And here we go. Wade heading to the hoop. And that one's good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
The Heat making a switch here. Bosh is checked in. That one misses for Wade. Bulls trail by 12. Noah with a screen on Wade. In the corner, it's McDermott. Right wing. Passes it to Noah. Rose up on top. to the left wing. No one near Felton as he lets it go. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Rose has got his third assist on the night. Now here's Freak. He's covered by Rose. And here's Freak. He's got eight. Wing shot on the way. Good. He hits the jump shot. Freak's got 10 points in the game.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Felton kicks it to Noah. Back to Felton. Gibson against Bosch. It's off his foot. And it's whistled a kick.
Chicago timeout call. Give it up for your Heat Dancers.
Big bodies and soft hands. Well, that's what these guys possess. The top assisting centers and power forwards this year. Third is Joakim Noah.
It takes a tremendous feel for the game to be able to make the passes these big guys are capable of making out of the low post.
Man, it's so much fun to watch a big guy handling and orchestrating things from the lane. I mean, it causes so many problems when you've got a guy who can score down there who also has vision and an excellent basketball IQ.
And not a night he's going to want to remember, just not really able to score the basketball. Really crisp, intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
Bulls trail by 14. Rose passes to Noah. Back to Rose. Tipped away. Nice D from Freak.
Well, they've only got a slight edge in rebounding when you look at the numbers, but it certainly feels a lot bigger than it is.
Yeah, the score has a lot to do with that. Their overall effort and execution has been elite. An open jump shot there, and their D not putting up any resistance today.
Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
And so he owns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Can I hit one of y'all cigars? Okay.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Heat.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
Something else they've been able to do so far tonight is earn those tough points in the paint.
There's the pick. Wade dishes to Freak. Offline with his three. Bulls trail by 15. Felton with the ball. Wade picks him up. Now here's Rose. He's got nine. And Gibson kicks to Rose. Shot clock at five. And stolen by Whiteside. And there's Dwayne Wade on the assist by Whiteside. 6 points for Wade.
Well, that's three of their last five baskets in transition.
You can see the emphasis is to get out and run.
Wade against Felton. Here's Gibson up and in from the low block. Gibson's got 7 points.
Boy, that was a pretty feed from Raymond Felton.
The Heat leading by 15. Here's Freak. He's got 12. Whiteside a screen. Freak passes to Whiteside. Here's Freak. Joakim Noah grabs the miss. Noah's got 4 rebounds now tonight. And Whiteside.
Thank you.
Sends it back. And here we go. Fast break. Wade's got it. Takes a three. And that one's good.
Three for one.
Freaks got 7 points for the quarter.
Man, that is not an easy shot right there. I mean, he had to get it off over a much taller defender.
Yeah, he needed to add just a little more loft on that one because of the size mismatch, and he did it perfectly.
Noah with a screen for Felton. Let's it fly. The offensive rebound, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And there's the call. Miami with the foul. The Bulls have gone 6 of 8 from the free throw line tonight.
Two shots.
That free throw, no good. The Heat making a switch here. Stoudemire's checked in. And the Bulls making a change here as well. Jimmy Butler, he's checked in for Raymond Felton. Second free throw, no good. The Heat leading by 18. Freak with it, now defended by McDermott. Freak with it, working on Noah. And here's Bosch for three. Second shot opportunity, that's good. And it's 6 points for Stoudemire.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Greg, the play in the paint has gone almost entirely all their way.
Okay, Miami, now coming out of the court are your Heat answers. Let them hear ya.
Take a moment to see some numbers for Dame. How last month turned out for him? He's averaging 8 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. And you look at those numbers, not bad. But guys, I think he can do better, and he knows it.
And he has high expectations for himself as well, guys, but he just hasn't delivered fully on his potential yet.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Portis comes in for Joakim Noah. And Mirotic subbed in for Taj Gibson. There's the pick. Now Butler. 9 points in the game so far. That's good from Mirotić on the assist by Butler. 8 points for Nikola Mirotić. The Heat leading by 17. Freak with it. 15 points in the game. Mirotić brings the double team. It's Bosch with the drive. And he banks in the lane. Bosch has got 15.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Well, the defensive rotations, Greg, have been a step slow, and it's really helped them get that ball inside time after time. It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady with their work on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
Let's it go from 11, and that one's good. Freak. Freak's got 9 points in the quarter.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
I'd agree with you, and I don't think they expected this one to be a game where they would get battered inside like they have.
And now he's taken a solid opening in the quarter and built on it here in the second.
Miami's gotten into trouble with the three ball in the second quarter, only hitting 1 of 5 attempts. Derrick Rose grabs the miss.
Well defended, though, and he's not someone who handles that kind of pressure very well.
Now here's Freak. Defense right on him. Rose with the double team. Stoudemire goes in. The three from Bosch. That ball is good for another field goal. His sixth. He is 6 for 9 on the stat sheet.
Now he's starting to pick up from what he accomplished in the first quarter, where he made 3 of his 3-point attempts.
Pulls up on the elbow, and it's Rose missing.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Here's Freak. Mirotić brings the double team. Shots good by Bosch.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
That's right. 5 of their last 6 makes were on the interior. They've established their inside presence.
Rose, no good.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Now here's Freak. He's covered by Rose.
Move the ball. Stick it too much.
Freak kicks to Stoudemire. That one goes in for him, too, making it look easy. He's now 4 for 4.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
Mirotić gets the bucket.
You can't afford to give him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
There's the steal. Rose goes in all alone. And good. He got the English that time as it falls. Rose has got 9 points now in the quarter.
The mid-range jumper is a high percentage shot for him. And when he's got that much room, forget about it.
Wade on the wing, defended by Butler. And that one's good. Freak.
Well, I tell you what, he's having one of those days where if he takes it, he makes it.
Chicago's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. Rose attacking. Here's Mirotić. Miami grabs the miss. Stoudemire's got 3 rebounds now in this one.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
And guys got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
That's exactly the way to do it, too, Kevin. Go hard to the bucket, and don't let them set up the defense.
A dominating first half of basketball, and so far hasn't been close. It's the Heat running away with it. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Certainly good numbers from you shooting the ball in the first half. What has been your approach on offense?
I'm just trying to let the game come to me. When I'm trying to force it on offense, good things happen. That's why I've had success here.
Slow and steady wins the race, Kevin.
Thank you so much, Doris. Great interview as always. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back with a second half of basketball shortly.
All right, guys, great first half. Home fans are loving it. Still want to go over a couple of things, though. This is the sort of offensive rhythm we know we're capable of when we put our mind to it. I like that we're active, moving our feet, making the right passes. On the other hand, I was happy with the pressure we put on them with our D and the steals we got out of it. Let's keep that heat on them. And let's try to play the second half at a moderate pace. Not too slow, but not too fast that it turns into a shootout. That's not what we want. I don't care what the score is.
Okay, Miami, now coming out of the court.
Now it's been a one-sided affair so far through the first two quarters, but there's plenty of time to mount a comeback.
Talk about complete control. Everything working in this one for Freak. He has 20 points and 9 assists.
Offensively, defensively, man, he has done it all.
All hustle, nonstop effort. He just doesn't quit. Great resilience and relentlessness in his play.
So for Chicago right now, Rose is the one with Butler as the two. The big men are Gibson and Noah, and it's McDermott in at the small forward.
Plus 8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Outside, Gibson kicks it to Rose. Noah with a screen for Rose. Out to the right wing. It's stolen by Wade. Left side, Bosch. Not enough on that one as it misses.
Man, that is a missed opportunity right there.
And he'll be the first to tell you, Greg, that's one he should have knocked down.
Butler with room to shoot. And it's Miami with the rebound. Whiteside's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. And here's Freak. Pass to Whiteside. Dang, dishes to Freak. Six to shoot. And Gibson over to help. They get the rebound. Whiteside. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
If you battle for the offensive rebound and come up with it, you're guaranteed a high-quality shot on a follow just like he got there.
And Gibson kicks to Butler. Gibson the screen. Butler against Wade. Outside, Rose. From outside the arc. Shot is off. And Miami the other way now.
And they start the second half with three straight misses.
Now here's Freak, defended by Butler. McDermott with the double team. Freak kicks to Whiteside. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. That's on Joakim Noah.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials.
Winslow's checked in for Luol Deng. Both free throws good from Wade. For Chicago, they've gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second half. Rose goes in. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. Rose has got 17.
Maybe with that, the lid on this basket will be lifted for him.
Now here's Freak. Tight defense on him. Used the shot fake to create the angle, but couldn't get it to fall. Noah the screen. Rose with the ball. Now defended by Freak. Rose passes to Gibson. That's good.
How about battling?
So it's both teams making substitutions here. Chicago has gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. Right at the free throw line, Stoudemire grabs the miss. Stoudemire's got his fifth rebound in this one. Stoudemire with a screen on Buck and stolen by Mirotić. Goes up, goes straight to the defender for the dunk, draws the foul. He'll go to the line. It's going to be on Freak.
You know what? He wasn't going to wait around for any help on that break.
Solo sore performance all the way. How about that for a little bit of a limerick?
Move the ball. Stick it too much.
I'm going to let it slide.
He used that pick to get in close. 22 points for Chris Bosh.
And that's sort of been the story here today, hasn't it?
Outside Rose. Bosch grabs the miss.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Got it. Get the ball inside.
Now here's Freak. He's covered by Rhodes. Freak gets to Bosh. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there.
You know, Bosh is playing really well. 22 points, and those four three-pointers he's hit have helped him, too.
No doubt, Barbet be in a much different position this game if he wasn't knocking down those triples.
And so Bosh nails both of them. Well, Chicago has gone outside a lot tonight. 17 times, in fact. 7 of 17. Outside Rose, stolen by Bosh. And here we go, Freak heading to the hoop. The basket good off the assist from Wade. And that's now 25 points for Freak. Let's look at the energy stats, how the hustle game has been going for the Heat.
Boy, they're hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end. Very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
They have, but you also can't overlook how well they've defended the rim, as they've challenged every shot and also gotten quite a few blocks as well.
And it's Stoudemire at the elbow. Good. Stoudemire's got 10 points.
He has such a nice touch for a big man.
Yeah, and they've got to figure out a way to get a bigger body on him, because if they don't match up his size, then he's going to continue to work them over the rest of the game.
Freak with it, and Rose picks him up defensively. Feeds to Wade, lets it go from deep, and again, Miami with the triple.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all day. Even last game, he was on fire.
Rose attacking. Oh, went in there and tried to power it down, but drew contact. He'll head to the line. That one is on Stoudemire. Bulls have made 7 of their last 12 attempts at the line.
And they've been mediocre all season long, just about 72% from the line.
You know, I know that's an aspect they've been trying to address as a team. I mean, they've got to get those free throw numbers up and improve.
And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. It's the Heat running away with this one. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. Welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail-biter here, but you never know. Heat shooting so well, the offensive execution has been brilliant. 66% from the field. Freak, he's in at point guard. Johnson is out there with Wright. Then there's Richardson, and it's McRoberts in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group in the game for the Heat. Here's Temple. They set the screen. Rose attacking, and it's Freak with the rebound. Freak's got his third rebound tonight.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
Rose dishes to Bearstone, knocks it loose. Looking to get back on track here, and the basket by Rose. Rose has got 21.
And their solid play in the paint continues, guys.
And that's been their focus, it seems, throughout the game. I like the discipline that they've showed in terms of creating those opportunities on the inside.
Freak passes to Wright. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Freak. Chicago grabs the miss. And Temple kicks to Rose. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. Rose has got 4 points in the quarter.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
Off target on the 3 from Freak. For Chicago, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. There's the screen. Rose dishes to Bearstow. Right side Rose.
It's Chicago with Aaron another Rose. Bucket. For Miami, they've gone 1-4 since the end of the third quarter. Now here's Freak. Tight defense on him. And McRoberts kicks to Richardson. And the shot is good.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
The Bulls have gone 3-4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Outside Rose, off the pick. And he goes in for the dunk.
And a sturdy screen set for him that time. And he doesn't fool around, just straight to the rim for the finish.
No way for his man to get around that one. That's for sure.
No chance, Kevin. I mean, the screen was in the right spot. His feet were set. He would have had to go straight through him, and that's not legal.
Richardson, and it's good. He planted his feet on the pick and shield the defender off.
Great job of utilizing that screen and finding space to knock down the jumper. Good basketball.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Here's Temple. Richardson covering. Baseline try. There still misses. Miami's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Freak passes to McRoberts. And another basket for Miami.
And really, he's just done a great job of finding the open man every trip down.
Boy, it sure has seemed as though he's done it every time. It's been an awesome display of passing for him today.
They set the pick. Over to the wing. Rose against Wright. A feed to Dunlap. Front pass the arc. No luck. And Miami the other way now. Next up for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. That'll be the last of three straight at home for the team. Johnson the screen. Here's Freak. And that basket is going to count. Goaltending the official call.
He thought he had that one clean, but the ref saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
Goran Dragic has checked in for Miami. Raymond Felton, he's checked in for Chicago. The Bulls have gone. And some changes here for the Heat. Stoudemire's checked in for Josh McRoberts. Winslow comes in for Wright. And Freak subbed in for Goran Dragic. Outside Rose. Gibson setting a pick for Rose. Drops in the tray. Rose has got 30.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. You can safely say mission accomplished now for the Heat.
When you consider the difference in their field goal percentages, the other team has to be happy that this wasn't a bigger loss. This team was on fire.
Yeah, you know what, Kevin? It's got to be frustrating to shoot so poorly when the other team is on fire.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
And, Greg, we know familiarity breeds contempt. I would expect things to become more heated as these teams face each other going forward.
You know, it always takes someone stepping up, and that happened here as well with some great numbers for Freak. A big part of their success was his ability to keep the ball moving, finding guys when they would flash open.
There's 25 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Winslow, wide open, he fires, and he's good on the three ball.
And they're not finished just yet. They're going to make sure about this win.
Yeah, not taking any chances, Greg. This is how you close a game out. Textbook.
Gibson the screen. Three-pointer, Butler. But they recover it.
There's another opportunity, and everything's going right for these guys.
And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. It was a tale of two teams tonight, one that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and Clark the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
Well, I think these fans, too, Kevin, gave their team a tremendous lift. I mean, they never gave up on them. From the opening tip until the end of the game, they were in it. And that certainly helped this crew get to the W.
And now we're going to sit down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
We're fucking with this chick. We've been knowing for a long ass time.
probably for like 7-8 years some shit.
Well, big numbers for you on the offense.
But he was doing things
to consistently get your shot.
Fuck around, cheat on the nigga or whatever. That nigga put her out.
It was all about working with Boston to open up scoring opportunities.
Yeah, she had cheated on him.
Not just for myself, for all of
us. He had put her out and shit. She had moved out to Atlanta with her people.
Better off we are in the end.
Well done. Kevin, over to you.
Thank you, Doris. Great interview once again.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast.
For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our entire 2K Sports crew. Thanking you for tuning in.
Hit me up this morning.
And now time to go to Ernie Johnson, who's alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports post-game
show. Got some shit going on and shit. He called her deep dish because the bitch...
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith.
Yeah, God,
without further ado,
with
let's present to you our Jordan player of the game.
And he goes to the crib.
He played the point with absolute precision.
This bitch.
16 assists.
Dish
not
people.
An easy number to come by. You got to be completely focused
she
on
ate both of
the
motherfuckers.
On every single possession. And he had everybody in sync at all times. That was a beautiful performance.
So he called her deep dish.
The contribution he gave with his long range shooting tonight. He was on fire. That turned out to be the big key for them. If someone drove the lane and the defense collapsed.
Oh yeah, we got a nice little point guard coming along. I got that behind the cross crossover
and
bag.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you enjoyed the show. For myself, Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew. Have a wonderful evening.
I think I like 9 bags. I play more minutes than everybody on this motherfucker now.
And I'm gonna have Eraser in a minute.
Huh?
I'm gonna have Eraser in a minute.
Are you playing?
Yeah.
Okay.
I ain't got shit else to do now. Shit, I ain't gotta go to fucking work.
Get all the badges. I got behind the back pro, flashy passer, killer crossover, pick a roll maestro. Hesitant stunner, master of in and out, cool and collected, low ego, and spark plug. So we got a nice little point guard for them niggas now, a little bit. Overall, a 73. I'd have dunked on like 2 niggas. Like I got 15. I've been doing them assists like crazy.
With their
I'm gonna get that shit for dunking on niggas in a minute too. I've dunked on so many niggas that 7 foot.
Bro. If I could send you a video of these highlights, nigga, I just did one of the coldest crossovers on D-Rolls and just shit it on like 2 niggas.
That's what's up, though.
I'm trying to get that shot creator, dog.
You expect coach to shake things up to try to jumpstart you in the third? All right.
Let me start. I mean, I broadcasted two games straight, so this is nice. I got some nice little broadcasting going on. I'm coming. So I'm about to start broadcasting right now. Save that little clip for the vids and shit.